1 through 2030, we can expect a dramatic escalation in the agenda. This escalation will likely come in waves where everything seems as if it's okay for a while, then there's a new problem. That new problem could be something such as a cyber attack that temporarily takes down the power grid in most parts of the internet, leading to another shortage in the food supply. Then, after some time, that will calm down, but the solution to the problem will be to increase restrictions online to verify everyone's identification. Ultimately, this is to further silence the citizens from speaking out. Then, after a series of events, we should expect another major wave of COVID variants, along with waves of lockdowns. As that subsides, it would again bring additional restrictions. Without any influence by us, it's plausible in the next few years to expect these events, along with a likely economic collapse, possibly culminating in a major war by the end of the decade. This wave pattern brings us, the subjects, right to a breaking point before relieving the pressure. It allows a gap to forget the previous hard time and accept it as normal, which reduces the threat of building a resistance. With every new problem comes more restrictions. This pattern provides an opportunity for the most effective way to demoralize the subject, making them exploitable to give up their rights for a sense of security, while channeling them to a modified, more controlled way of living.
This pandemic has provided an opportunity for a reset. Building back better means getting support to the most vulnerable while maintaining our momentum on reaching the 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development and the SDGs.
The third foundation is to build back better.
To think that life can go on as it was before the plague. And it will not. This government will build back better.
We can build back better. And I'm looking forward to getting started as soon as we can.
They all have ties to each other through trade and promise of deals to them if they comply. How could they resist when evil consumed their hearts from the beginning when power was first given to them? Communist dictators only see the greater good in their own selfish pursuits and benefits, which relies on the city systems to function as a well-oiled machine, treating its worker citizens as their property and its fuel, rather than people, of which they dictate virulently. They will always lie and fight dirty to win over their will, using power plays on the people, because there is no limit to power for them. None of this can be an accident. The timing is too convenient and the benefits always go back to the global elite and ruling class. Additionally, they used the media distraction to divert attention to sneak in some more draconian laws to be passed. Here are some of the bills that were voted on while you all were scared and with your attentions kept preoccupied with a sudden threat to your security and livelihood.
And I would say that they have a duty to sit back, watch, behave, wash their hands, stay in the apartment with mom and dad. They look like they're lucky to have you as a father. And just learn from it.
The stay-at-home enforcement is a psychological practice run, which, in essence, likely mimics introverted living, preparing millennials to cope with self-containment the way they will be held in FEMA camps. They are also using this chance to test out universal basic income, while preconditioning everyone to psychologically get used to the system failing, so that everyone will be mentally stable when the big one hits, and will be expecting their rescue. The Corona simulation seeks to condition you to value authority as trustworthy and helpful to coexist with and live under in a state of emergency. They want you to see military personnel as your friends and get you used to their uniforms and level of control over you. The sum of all of these changes happening at once are presets for Agenda 2030, which, referring back, is a plan to reset society and reboot it to a dramatically different system, which requires the old system to be destroyed. A new system which seeks to spy on every citizen's daily actions, with even more stricter surveillance to rank all citizens as the Chinese do to their people. A system which seeks to eliminate cash and property ownership, and go completely digital using RFID microchip hand implants to replace credit cards. A system which seeks to eliminate all classes, personal belongings, and assets, while promising to treat everyone to the same shared experience of life under a socialist utopia, gifted to you by Big Brother and the all-watching eye of its tentacles of power. Agenda 2030 is not a utopia for those who value freedom, traditional family, and privacy. This is why we see these rights today being trampled over now. They are testing to see how much you are willing to give up in trade for more and more security, and free stuff. It is human bait to trap you, luring you to enslavement. Do not let it tempt you. This kind of future is pure imprisonment of free will itself, and is a death-promised servitude to serve your all-ruling masters of the state. To stop it, you're going to need to arm yourself with knowledge and grow with our already growing resistance. With the new powers gained from this pandemic scare, the elite plan to use them to purposely destabilize the already fragile United States economy, and ignite a class war with the target of destroying the middle class. Non-essential businesses are being liquidated. Businesses everywhere are already refusing to accept cash with fear of transmitting the virus on circulating dollar bills. After all this, they can use it as an example of how the fiat cash-based currency reached its finish, and then go on to form a cashless society from the wake of the chaos. If we don't call them out now as a collective or take actions to stop them, they are just going to continue to make even more devastating power plays like they did this year to bring all nations down to their knees and keep the poor begging the rich for a solution, which they already premeditated and pre-mapped out precisely for this moment, and it is called Agenda 2030. Please follow the links below to learn more about Agenda 2030. What you are seeing is a ruling strategy of intentionally causing the problem only to own the pre-planned solution in the end. They wanted us to peacefully hand them this power with our belief in man-driven climate change. But now, since they saw the massive negative reactions and doubts to their climate change campaign they've ran for decades, they have now switched their methods to a more sinister plan to seize global control of all commerce and sovereignty. Please remain vigilant and do not trust the same people that used 9/11 to forge the Patriot Act in place. Stop trusting your presidents and prime ministers. They all have reserved hideaway spots in subterranean bunkers which they pledge allegiance for. They all are in on this together, and their MO is exactly the same each time they use it, and this should all be too familiar to you by now.